Okay, here we are. Wednesday night, May 1st, 2013. A couple of very short articles by Rabbi Ouziel, on the holiday of Shabou'ot, and then a much lengthier article, if we do get to it, then we'll title it. So we have from Ham Ouziel, Mahmune Ouziel Halik Bet. This is Perek Het Ma'amal Lamet Het. We're on page 139, topic of Shabu'ot, and the subtopic here is Shene Ketarim, the two crowns. Ve'atem tehiyu li memlechet kohanim ve'goy kadosh. Okay? Borei Olam, later on in the Torah, we're supposed to be to him, memlechet kohanim, a kingdom of kohanim, kingdom of priests, ve'goy kadosh, and a holy nation. We're two things. Hamalchut v'akedusha hem shnei haketarim shenitnu la'am Yisrael b'ma'amad har Sinai al yedei malachei hashirei v'al yedei adon hanabiyim v'noten haTorah. Okay, so we have two things that are given to us, the Malchut and the Kedusha. These are the two ketarim, the two crowns that were given to Am Yisrael at Ma'amad har Sinai through the angels and through the master of all the Nebi'im who gave us the Torah, Moshe Rabbeinu. Vehem hem haketarim shehobil otam Yisrael bechol nidudei gelduto veshamar otam benishmato vesibyono. And these crowns gave the shape and the semblance and the creed and the color to Am Yisrael that carried us through all the different generations, all the different turmoils, and allowed us to keep the image of who we are.
באלפי שנות גלות ונידוד לא נכנע ישראל לפני נוגסיו.
Okay, through the thousands of years of the גלות. No matter what, whoever came tried to destroy us, to oppress us, we didn't give up.
אלא עמד בקומה זקופה בדמותו של מרדכי לא יכרע ולא ישתחווה.
We basically portrayed Mordechai. Mordechai did not budge. He would not bow, he would not prostrate, he would not move. That's Am Yisrael.
ולא חילל לקדושתו התורנית אשר קיבל מהר סיני מידי קדוש ישראל וגואלו.
He did not abandon the Torah. Not one iota.
ואם אתה רוצה לדעת, שא ובדוק בבתי ישראל ובבתי הכנסת והמדרש בימי השבתות והמועדים ותראה את הוד מלכות וקדושת הנשמה האופפת עליהם מרוממת אותם אל עולם האסילות של הוד מלכות וקדושה עליונה.
And if you have any doubts, you're not sure, wait for any Shabbat, any holiday, walk into the Jewish home, walk into the synagogue, walk into the Beit Midrash, you see it. You see Am Yisrael in all its glory. You see who we are, how we congregate, how we pray, how we study, how we're glorified, how, you know, we have a different glow, if you will, to us than anybody else. It's there. And it's true. If you walk into a place that's bristling with activity on Shabbat, you're like, ah, this is great, you know. And the place is empty. Obviously, you're not going to feel it, but, you know, when the place is full, you definitely send something.
שני כתרי כבוד בתפארה אלה מתחדשים בזוהרם שנה שנה ביום חג השבועות. זה מה מתן תורתנו שבו אנו קוראים פרשה נהדרת זאת שהיא יחידה בזוהרה בכל הספרות העולמית.
So what is Rabbi Ouziel telling us over here? These two crowns, the kabod, the honor, בתפארה, and the glory, they renew themselves with their shine from year to year on the holiday of Shabu'ot, the time of receiving the Torah, when we read this amazing parasha that he tells us it stands unique in all world literature. Pasuk is very, very simple.
Hashama'am kol Elohim kasher shama'ata atta v'yehi.
You're hearing God's voice. We were there. We heard God's voice. It was instilled in us. It's something that we remember. Even though we in our regular memories, we cannot, you know, yeah, I heard the voice, I know what it sounds like, but it's there. There is some sort of spark, some sort of connotation, some, you know, some connection that we have to this pasuk.
Ketrei zahav ille hebriku le'ainenu b'chol zoharam b'yimei melchemet ha'geula v'ha'chirut sheba'adamat nahalatenu v'eres kodshenu v'hem hem she'atru etchem benim yekarim v'ahim ahubim sib'ot Yisrael b'atheret nisahon v'tif'ara she'atheret melchut kudusha.
Now you have to see, Rabbi Ouziel is writing this, okay, April 1949. In other words, this is the first Shabu'ot, you know, technically, not the first Shabu'ot after the State of Israel, but after that first war, because immediately after the peace, okay, they had the War of Independence, right? And but this time now it's the first Shabu'ot after that War of Independence. So it's amazing. So he's saying, you Am Yisrael, you my brothers and sisters, you people that are here in front of me, you people that are listening to me speak, people that are reading this article in the newspaper, you know, it's all you. And we all felt it together. This is what bonded us, you know, what really came to light to ourselves and to the world that we're special, that we're different, that we have something, we have this kedusha, we have this malchut. These crowns are on our heads. They're there. And they didn't come together in any time like now, when we fought together for the sake of our land. It's just amazing what he probably lived through, what he saw, what he was feeling, you know, to speak to the people like this. And look how he refers to it. Ba'adamat nahalatim. This is the land. This is our portion. This is our inheritance. Be'eretz kodeshenu, our holy land. Ve'hem hem sha'atru etchem banim yekarim ve'achim ahuvim sevot Yisrael. And he calls the army, he calls them dear brothers, honored brothers. That's how he refers to the army. Not like people today, they curse the army or they make fun of the army. No. He's praising them. Alteret nisahon. You have this crowning glory of victory. And this is the crown of the Malchut and the crown of the Kedusha. He's praising them. How lucky you are that you had the Zechut to be in the army. You had the Zechut to fight for Eretz Israel. And you're alive and you could see what we have now. Lirot Malchut Medinat Israel, the kingdom of the state of Israel. You get to see it. Our fathers, our grandfathers, the fathers before that, all our ancestors, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, you know, close to 2,000 years, only dreamt of this. And they prayed for it day and night. They never got to see it. You got to make it happen and you got to see it. And we are standing here, we feel the honor among ourselves, and the nations of the world, they're standing in awe. They don't understand it, they don't believe it. How people that were no training, no real army, no nothing, all of a sudden you give them a state, and everybody figured, okay, they're going to wipe us off the map, and it's over within a few hours. We're here. We've come home.
Lechu bekohachem ze banim yikarim v'habibim ud'u ki alunai malach al kol ha'aris holech lefnechem b'chol asher telechu lehadof oibichem p'nechem v'shameru et machanechem behod malchut shel gibura v'romemut haruach b'dushat go'alin v'adunai sevot shemukot Yisrael v'haya machanechem kadosh.
Go home knowing that you are protected. You are one with God. God is one with you. We're all together. God is finally redeeming us. God is saving us. And now all our homes, all our land, all our country is kadosh.
Beyom kadosh ze, yom matan toratenu, נזכרו ויפקדו לטובה חללינו הגיבורים שנפלו בכל חזיתות המלחמה ושדות המערכה. On this day, this holy day of Matan Torah, this day of Kiddusha of Am Yisrael, this is when we're going to remember. When we're going to remember all the amazing deeds that the heroes that fell for the sake of this land went through. This is their day, just as much as it's your day. And this is when we're going to remember them, because the Kiddusha of the Torah is the Kiddusha of these soldiers and generals, you know, and lieutenants, etc. נשמתם תהיה סלולה בסור החיים ותרעדן בזיו השכינה וזרעם יירש ארץ. And these people, obviously their neshama will be, you know, encompassed and enveloped, you know, in with all the living. But not only that, but they're going to enjoy the Shekhinah. And their descendants are going to be zocheh, and they're going to inherit, what do you call it, the nahala of the Eretz, the physical land, you know, because now their children and their grandchildren will be living in Israel. But because of the deeds that they did, that they fought for Israel, they also zocheh the adamah above. Ve'atem giborei ha'il, kasinecheim ve'alufeichem, sisu v'simchu. Now he's thanking the army generals and lieutenants that are still alive, and telling them, be happy. V'chedvat Hashem tiyeh ma'uzdechem. V'kol ahai, rabot b'shanim b'minayat Yisrael yarum hoda v'yitnaseh malchuta l'olamim. He's connecting Matan Torah to the Matana that God is giving us of Israel. The Kedushah of the Torah, Kedushah of Israel. The crowns of the Torah to the crowns that we now have as a nation back in our homeland. And he's praising all the people involved. To me, this is something we don't see nowadays. All we see is people shambling the government, shambling the state. How did we go and take it on our own? It's not time for the Mashiach. No. Here it is, he's telling you. And these guys, they get automatic Gan Eden. He's telling them, you have Gan Eden, guaranteed. Beautiful. I think when I read it this morning, I looked at it, I said, this is just so touching. You know, so I find it special because we don't hear anything like this.
Where was he born?
Rabbi Ouziel?
Yeah, in Turkey,
he was
right?
Born in Israel.
He was born in
Israel. Oh, yes, he was. In Yerushalayim, Eid Atika, in the old city.
And he lived there his whole life? No.
Did he live there his whole life? He left for a short period to Greece. Very short period, though. But he was in Yerushalayim, he was in Tel Aviv, and back to Yerushalayim. Okay, second article by Rabbi Ouziel on Hag HaShabu'ot. Mu'ayid Yom HaShishi V'Chodesh HaShilishi Nikra B'Lashon HaTorah Hag HaShabu'ot Lefi Shebo Nishlemu Sheb'a Shabu'ot Miyom Yisiyat Yisrael B'Misraim Ad Yom Ma'amad Harsina Hinefla Shesafu Elav Yisrael B'Kimiha Nafshit B'Simma'on Lohet לראות התגלות אלוהים בהודו והדרו, ולשמוע כל אלוהים המדבר אל עמו בחירו, ונותן לו תורת אמת וחיי עולם. So he's saying the holiday that falls out on the sixth day of the third month is called in the words of the Torah, Hag HaShabu'ot. And why is it Shabu'ot? Because obviously we know this is the culmination of the seven Shabu'ot, the 7 weeks from leaving Bnei Yisrael, leaving Mitzrayim, until Ma'amad Har Sinai. And that was a time that they were looking forward to, you know, both physically and spiritually, and they couldn't wait to see Borei Olam and to hear his voice, you know, speaking to, you know, to this one nation, this Am Segula, that was promising them Torat Emet, the Torah of truth, which obviously gives eternal life. שבעה שבועות אלה היו לישראל יוסעי מצרים ימי הכשרה והתכוננות להתנער מעבדות מצרים ותומעתה והתלבש בחילות הנפש וקדושתה שהיא תנאי יסודי לקבלת תורה. These 7 weeks were basically a time of preparation, a time of basically koshering their minds, their bodies, their souls, to shake off all, you know, the slavery that they had, all the tum'ah that they had, and to redress themselves. Okay, to redress their souls with kiddushah. Because this kiddushah is an essential foundation to accept the Torah. Shetar hirut amitit, hirut al-nishama v'amma hashaba. New contract had to be drawn up. A contract of true freedom. A contract of freedom of the neshama and of the mahashaba. The mahashaba is the thought process. The way you know, your outlook, the way you think about things. Hamma'asev ha-dibur. It had to, you know, be new people completely. The way they thought, the way they spoke, the way they acted. Hamba'a'ekib bihira havshit v'tibunatit. Shehi tif'irat na'usiyah v'tif'irat lo min ha'adam. Ukhtibre rabbutein v'zikhronan l'bracha. Harut al halluhot. Atikri harut illa harut. So saying the letters were engraved on the tablets, right? The Ten Commandments were engraved harut. And the Hachamim tell us, don't read it as harut engraved, illa harut, freedom. Harut mimalach mavet, mishaibud malchuyot. Once you accept the Torah, you are accepting upon yourself freedom. Freedom from the outside forces. Freedom from the angel of death. Freedom from being subservient to other nations. Shekol Adam, Sheporek Me'alav, Ol Malchut Shamayim Ve'ol Mizvot. Any person that throws off himself the yoke of the Torah, the yoke of the Mizvot, the yoke of Borei Olam, Eino Illa Ebed Nirsa L'me'avayi HaYeser V'Hamdot HaGuf Shizofar HaPach Nefesh V'Darchem Mavet. Because all that does for you, you think you're becoming a freer person. I don't need God, I don't need Torah, I don't need anything, your freedom. But you're only giving in to all your desires. And you're becoming a slave to your desires and nothing else. You have no freedom whatsoever. Sha'ibut ha-guf shel shelton adam ba'adam l'ra'lo. And all you're doing, you see people are subservient to each other. Oh, I can't do this because this guy is going to want me to do that. And then I have to play this political game to work for this guy. Stay straight with the Torah and everything works out. Once you throw off the Torah and you become a slave to other people, basically this is the destruction of mankind, the destruction of the world. The acceptance of the Torah.
The benefit of the Torah.
The benefit of accepting the Torah on Shabu'ot. About a Hirut ha-mitit, but the true Hirut, the true freedom, he could debrer bi-hudah ha-levi. Ha-shta'abedut li-mi shira'ui, bi-lema shira'ui mitok bi-hira v'tibuna. Zot hi Hirut gimura u-muhletet. The Hirut zot, Zachu Yisrael Ahare Sifirat Shiv'a Shabu'ot Shekadmu L'matan Torah V'hekshiru Otam L'kabbalata Me'ahaba Shidbata'a Be'omram Kol Asher Dibbir Adonai Na'aseh V'nishma'a. And Borei, and the people knew it. They knew that this is their real freedom. And they knew the only way they're going to be able to get rid of everything else is by accepting the Torah. And that frees them from all shi'ibud malchuyot. Dibur shemalachei asherei mishtamshim bo. Sasim usmehim la'asur usum konam be'ahaba v'ir'a simha v'sahala. Basically, a play on the words of what we say in simehim b'satam on Shabbat. And what are you happy about? You're happy about accepting the Torah. About worshipping Borei Olam, about doing His will, because that gives the freedom. Once we accept the Torah, we became Am Segula, they opened up the doors to us. Yom Hag HaShabu'ot, Hu Eidut L'Kesher HaNishhi V'Haduk SheBin Yisrael Abihim SheBashamayim. The holiday of Shabu'ot is the tying testimony, the eternal testimony that connects Borei Olam and Am Yisrael. HaKadosh Baruch Hu Me'id Ve'Omer. Hashama Am Kol Elohim Edaber Mitoch Ha'esh. Kashi Shama'ata Atta Ve'yehi. Remember, we just read that pasuk in the previous article. Ve'Yisrael Afu Aoneh Ve'Omer. And B'nai Yisrael answers this pasuk, obviously, you know, about a parak later. Hayom Hazeh Ra'inu Ki Edaber Elohim Et Ha'adam Ve'Hai. We realize, yes, Borei Olam is going to speak. And even though we're hearing, we're not dying. Why aren't we dying? Because what we're hearing is the eternal Torah. And the Torah is causing us to live. That's the Baha'i. Idud ne'mana zot, he is so the ahad mi'ikareha Torah v'hayahadut. This testimony gives truth to one of the main foundations of the Torah and Judaism. Torah min hashamayim v'yesod kiyumo v'yesod nishiyuto shel am Yisrael k'nishiyut notena Torah v'torato. The Torah is from the Shamayim. It's not something that was written by mankind. Something is coming from Borei Olam. And it is the foundation of the existence and the foundation of the eternalness of Am Yisrael. And because of the Torah. He sha'amda la'abotenu velanu neged kol ha-ta'oriyot, ha-philosophiyot, ha-makhishot, ha-shgahat Elohim, ha-kirbato l'bnei Adam. This protected us. It stood in the way of any other sort of philosophy taking over. He sha'amda v'ta'amod lanu kol ha-yamim neged kol mizimot resha v'kohot ha-shema shekamu la-hashmid Am Yisrael v'akid Torah Elohim emet min ha-olam. And it stands in the way of anything that comes to wipe us out and wipe out our beliefs. Because we have the Torah and we follow the Torah and believe in the Torah. V'hi sha'amda lanu bedor tahpuchot ze lehafir mizimmatam hamelsha'at shel sorere Yisrael ha'amalekim shebedorenu shim omnam harbu halalenu v'hidiu harisotenu. Okay, he goes, in our generation, this particular one he wrote in 46. This is basically the end of World War II, the end of the Holocaust. He's saying, this, the Torah, is the only thing that stood in the way of the Amalekim of our door. The Amalekim of our generation. In other words, Hitler, the Nazis. Alright? To wipe us out completely. Because we believe in the Torah. But if we didn't, then everybody would have just fallen right away. In the end, they fell. They completely fell. Completely destroyed. The world attacked them. And in our very eyes, we saw the words of the Nabi of Yeshaya come true. You're going to see them. All the people that were attacking you, all of a sudden, like nothing, they're going to disappear. And it's true. The people were on the trains being taken to the death camps, and all of a sudden, the train just stopped, and the Nazis ran away. And nobody knew what... People on the train still, they didn't know what happened. You know? People in the camps, all of a sudden, the soldiers are running away. Nobody knew what was going on. All of a sudden, like exactly like the Pasuk. They were there, and then they were gone. It's like a wind came, a hurricane came, and blew them all away. And then all of a sudden, Tahil Badona, you're happy in God, thank you, God. And Am Yisrael is happy, and then all of a sudden, boom, here we are, we get Israel out of it. Hada Shabu'ot mithaddesh alinu shana shana ki yom ma'amad har Sinai. Maharat ha-Pesach, yom haga Torah, yom haga Herut, mizva alinu not imi ha-Omer. Because we have the beginning of the Herut comes with Pesach. And it culminates with the real Herut of the Torah. This is a short article that Rabbi Ouziel wrote at that time.
Rabbi
Ouziel, who was the chief rabbi.
Of?
He was the chief rabbi. The Rishon LeZion.
Ouziel?
Ouziel. You're kidding, right?
No, what year was that?
Rabbi Ouziel was the Rishon LeZion from 39 till 55. 1939 till 1955. 55. All right, so we're going to read an article down by Rabbi Uri Cherki. Rabbi Uri Cherki is a very modern Zionistic rabbi. He tries to incorporate teachings of Rabbi Kook with teachings of the Sephardi rabbis. He has a very interesting approach to things. And this looked like an interesting article. Obviously, it's too long for us to complete, but at least let's get started on it. Let's see if we have any positive ideas.
His own book, or it's from...
This is from one of his books, yeah. He has his own website with a million different articles on it, and he's written articles in different places as well.
Is this a Sam Cohen type of guy?
Is it a Sam Cohen type of guy? Sam Cohen is familiar with him also, but we both discovered him independently of each other. Okay, Sam. Haya Olam. Lo karat HaKadosh Baruch Hu berit im Yisrael illa al devarim she'al peh. She'ne'emar ki al pi ha'devarim ha'ele karati itecha berit ve'et Yisrael. In the Borei Olam, he established this berit with Am Yisrael only because of devarim she'al peh. We'll see what he means by that. Tochen ha'berit ha'miyuhedet she'karat Hashem Am Yisrael מתמסה בתורה שבעל פה ולא בתורה שבכתב. So now he's going a little further. It's not that this berit of בעל פה is, has to do with תורה שבעל פה. And that's really the gist of that berit בורי עולם had made with us. וחיי עולם נטע בתוכנו. זה תורה שבעל פה. That's a statement made in the tour. מלימוד דברי חז"ל עולה שקיימת הבחנה ברורה ומהותית בין שתי התורות. According to the Hachamim, there is a very, very clear distinction between Torah SheBikhtab and Torah SheBa'al Peh, what they are, what their purposes are, and what we get out of them. כך שכל אחת יכולה להיות למקור חיים העומד בזכות עצמו. Each one can really stand on its own. מתוך כך עלינו לברר את מהותה של Torah SheBa'al Peh בתור גלוי ייחודי שדבר השם מתגלה בתוכנו. And we're going to see how understanding what the Torah Sheba'al Peh is, how it stands alone within us, and how it reveals Borei Olam to us. מצווה לקרוא בתורה. יש לסלק תחילה מספר הבנות מוטעות. But first we have to get rid of mistaken notions. ההבנה המסויה היא שהתורה שבעל פה היא פירוש לתורה שבכתב. Alright? Common concept is that תורה שבעל פה is a פירוש לתורה שבכתב. Correct? That's what people generally think. לפי זה, משה קיבל את התורה שבכתב מסיני, ולאחר מכן באה התורה שבעל פה לפרש את מה שקיבלנו מסיני. So according to that, Moshe accepted the written Torah in Sinai, and afterwards, the Torah Sheba'al Peh came along to explain what we received at Sinai. Tefisa zo ena mabhina habhana mahutid bin shineha gilwiyim. Does not really show the difference between them, explain what they are and how it happened. Shekena Torah Sheba'al Peh masbira lanu et kabbanata ha'amitit shel ha'Torah Shebikhtab. Because Torah Sheba'al Peh explains to us what is the real intention of Torah Shebikhtab. Kach shenitan lehaniyah shim hayita lanu da'at yishara, hayinu mibinim et Torah Sheba'al Peh mitoch kidiat pisukeh shel Torah Shebikhtab. So that means that if we actually had clear thought, direct thought, understanding, we would understand on our own through the Pesukim of Torah SheBikhtab what the Torah is really trying to tell us, and we would automatically understand what is Torah Sheba'al Peh. We would know it on our own. אבל נראה שהחמינו זכרון הברכה תפסו את הדברים אחרת. But it seems, he's telling you, this is all incorrect, and the Hachamim saw it very differently. נתבונן במה שנאמר במסכת ברכות. First, he wants to look at מסכת ברכות. And this is from the beginning. דף עמוד א'. אמר בלוי בר חמה. אמר ריש לקיש. מה דכתיב? They're asking us, what is this פסוק in שמות? בתנא לך את לוחות האבן והתורה והמצווה שכתבתי להורותם. What is this פסוק? What does it mean? What's it coming to teach us? כשמשה עולה אל ההר, אומר לקדוש ברוך הוא שהוא עולה כדי לקבל חבילה של מתנות המפורטות בכתוב, לוחות האבן והתורה והמצווה אשר כתבתי להורותם. Basically, it seems to be that when Moshe is going up to Har Sinai, Borei Olam is basically telling him, come, I have a package for you. I have a habila, I have a package for you. Okay, it's not that I have the Torah for you. He's telling you, I'm going to give you Luhot HaEben, I'm going to give you Torah. I'm going to give you Mitzvah. I'm giving you at least three things based upon the Pasuk. Correct? Three separate things. Umefaresh Rish Lakish. Rish Lakish explains to us. Luhot ha'evin elu aseret ha'dibirot. Fine. Understood. Self-explanatory. Okay. The stone tablets are aseret ha'dibirot. Ha'dibarim mubanim. Shekein biluhot ha'evin ha'yukutuvim aseret ha'dibirot. And we know 10 commandments were engraved on those stones. Ve'ha'torah.
That's Torah SheBa'al Peh?
No, that's the 10 commandments only. 10 commandments were on the Luhot HaEben.
Right, oh, okay.
Right? You can't, you saw the movie right. A couple few weeks ago, right? You saw Charles Heston comes down, he has the stones. It's there, we all know it. Been watching it since we were born.
Classic movie.
Yeah, it's really the best movie. I can watch really it again is, and again. I can watch it a million times. Really is the best. So Luhot HaEben, we know what it is. The next thing in the Pasuk, the Torah. The Torah... Zeh Mikra. That's the Mikra. Okay? We know what the Mikra is. Vah Mizvah. What's the Mizvah? Zo Mishnah. Asher Ketabti. What's Asher Ketabti? Elu Nibi'im Uchtubim. Lohorotam. Zeh Talmud. Melamed Shekulam Nitenu LeMoshe Misinai. That means everything was given to Moshe Rabbeinu at Har Sinai based upon the explanation of Resh Lakish in the Gemara Masechet Berachot. Based off of this Pasuk. We're good so far, Mark? Yeah. We agree? Yeah, Barry.
The Pasuk V'etanel L'chai.
Yeah.
Lehorotam means like teachers?
Lehorotam, to teach them, to direct them. That's the Talmud. Aoleh Mikan, Shlefiya Talmud. HaTorah SheBa'al Peh, Kalomar HaMishnah, what's Torah SheBa'al Peh? It's the Mishnah. VaTorah SheBikhtab, Kalomar HaMikra, it's the Mikra. Nitenu Kulam MiSinai, they were all given at Har Sinai at the same time. Borei Olam to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe Rabbeinu, as we know from Mishnah, Moshe, Yoshua, Yoshua, the Skinim, etc., etc. HaMishnah Ba'a Betur Sinor, Hidgalut Yeshir Mepi HaGibura, העומד לפני עצמו ולא כפירוש התורה שבכתב. משנה, which is the Torah שבעל פה, or the, okay, came basically as a direct pipeline, okay, of explanation, of definition from the Gibura, from Borei Olam, directly to us. It's not a separate entity from Torah שבכתב, it's not a פירוש on Torah שבכתב. So this is part of the package. We got a package. אם אכן ניתנה התורה שבעל פה יחד עם התורה שבכתב, כבר לא ניתן לראות בה פירוש, כי לא ייתכן שספר יצטרך פירוש כבר בשעת כתיבתו. So now, if we're all in agreement that this is the case, that we've now received at the same giving, תורה שבכתב and תורה שבעל פה, we received that Torah, which is the Mikra, and the Mizvah, which is the Mishnah. We can't say now, on day one that we got the book, nobody read the book yet, nobody has the book, here's the book. I already wrote a commentary on it. Wait, there's a Pirush on it. There's no Pirush on it. You're getting two things. You have this and you have this. They work hand in hand with each other. But it's not a Pirush. Harambam. Okay.
Wait, what is he saying? I'm just not clear.
Okay, look. He says, "Im achen Torah Torah, if in fact, based upon what we read in Gemara Berachot, the Torah SheBa'al Peh was given together with Torah SheBikhtab, you cannot look at Torah SheBa'al Peh as a pirush,
right?
Because you cannot have a pirush, a book, the Torah SheBikhtab cannot need a pirush." Already from the first moment that it was written.
Who's saying this?
No, he's really saying it. Rabbi Cherki is saying this. Okay?
He's trying to do away with...
He's trying to do away with Torah SheBa'al Peh.
No, with this misnomer. He's saying this is a mistaken concept that people have, that Torah SheBa'al Peh is a pirush to Torah SheBikhtab.
Oh, okay.
He's saying this is wrong. And here, we saw Resh Lakish is telling us right now. Amar Rabbi Levi Barhama Amar Resh Lakish.
Yeah. He's telling us this is not what it is based upon simple understanding of Masechet Berachot. So why do we have this false idea? And what is the truth? That's what he's trying to explain to us first. He's trying to lay groundwork, it seems. So now he's going to Harambam.
But Reish Lakish is saying that they're together. They came together.
Right. They all came together. Right. It's all one package. We received a package deal from God.
But
okay?
That's what we received? The package deal? No.
You're saying it's parallel?
You don't think we're... Well,
what, we received the Torah SheBa'al Peh also at the same time?
Sure.
Well, actually, we received the Torah SheBa'al Peh before. The Kitab is only written in the 40th year. That's... I don't know what... Outside of Reish Lakish's Dirasha. Torah is really written... Or some... Torah is... It's in the Pesukim. It seems to be in Sefer Devarim. Really,
the Torah SheBa'al Peh, they're saying, is what? The Mishnah?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right. So, we received that when?
At Ma'amad HaSinai.
The Mishnah.
Yeah,
but it was written down later.
It was all orally. Right.
Some was forgotten, and that's where you have the mistakes.
That's the Rashi Lakish is saying.
Okay.
That's all.
However, they managed to remember, they wrote down the Mishnah. I think that's why they had to write it down, because they were...
At that point, yeah.
Right. The Torah SheBa'al Peh is not some explanation on the Torah SheBikhtab.
That's exactly what he's saying.
Right.
But when you have the whole... How many times do you have explanations on it? Go do this, and it explains, cut a giraffe, where's the spot, where's this, you know. It explains
Mishnah's
the law.
That's the Gemara. Not the Mishnah.
Well, I don't understand his question. What was he saying?
He's saying that a lot of times when they don't know something, you want to understand what's this pasuk, what's that?
Right.
So they tell you, they give you all these different explanations on
right.
it. So that's why they're telling you, he's telling you that Torah SheBa'al Peh is a perush on Torah SheBikhtab. But that all came later. You don't really see that in the Mishnayot.
Right. You don't see, right.
No, you see that in the Gemara.
You see that in the Gemara.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
13-minute mark.
Let's see what Mark said. Put it on.
Just to say, Hakteh Harambam and Hakteh Ma'ad Mishnah.
Right.
He writes, he makes that point that Torah is really written in the 40th year of the Kitav. It comes together as a book.
Okay.
As a Hibur or a Sefer.
Okay.
And so what was existing from Har Sinai until the Torah is written is Torah SheBa'al Peh. That's the Ikar is always till Torah SheBa'al Peh.
Well,
and the Kitab is like sourcing the Torah SheBa'al Peh. Yeah. That's Haram Baham's opinion.
Say that again?
The Ikar, the essential thing was Torah SheBa'al Peh. And that the Pesukim of the Torah are really citing, are like a footnote or a teaching of the Torah SheBa'al Peh.
So the Torah SheBa'al Peh came before Torah SheBikhtab.
That's what Rambam says in the Hakdeh Ma.
Well, let's see. I'm not really sure I agree with that.
I'll get it out.
Okay.
No, I'm not sure I agree with it.
Okay, it's fine. He does say that.
Let's see what he says over here, though, because now he's going to quote Harambam.
It's not this part.
No, obviously, a different part.
Mm-hmm.
Harambam in a different Hakdama.
Yeah.
Harambam masbir. Shepirushim nichtavim tamid bighlal hamirhat mizeman ahibur. Because Harambam explains to us that commentary, pirush, is always written on a work when a time has elapsed from the time that book was written. Because from the time the book was written till a later time, so what the book was really talking about is not understood. So you need to make a pirush, you need to write a commentary so the book will be understood. He goes, but when the book is first freshly written, it's all relevant. And all the players involved are around and everybody knows what's going on. So there's no need for the concept of a pirush. Especially if you have the author around, or in this case you have Moshe Rabbeinu, who is the transmitter.
That's a good point.
Very good point.
Excellent point.
No, because if you read a novel, if you read a book today, you understand all the nuances and the cultural aspects of it.
Right.
If I'm reading The Great Gatsby, if I'm reading Shakespeare, there's so much reference that I don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't live there.
We don't understand the time. We don't understand the history. We don't understand the culture. Nothing. Seven.
Exactly. 100%.
That's amazing.
It's Rambam. Ubdibri Rashi. Now let's see what Rashi says on that same Masechet Berachot that we're reading. Mikra Humash. Shemizva Likrot Batura. Okay. Let's see what he's trying to get at. Kelal Libmadnu Harab Yehuda Ashkenazi. שכשרשי אומר דברים פשוטים כל כך, זה סימן לדבר עמוק. So he's saying that, I guess one of his rabbis, Rabbi Yehuda Ashkenazi, taught them that any time that Rashi says something that seems so basic, and so simple, so babyish, that means he's really telling us something extremely deep. First, let's try to see the peshat of the intention of the Rashi. Ha-humash nikra mikra mishum sheyesh mizvah likruto. The humash is called mikra because there is a mizvah to read it. Al v'hamizvah zo mishnah. And then on that second part that we said Torah is the mikra, mizvah is the mishnah. So what is it? Rashi said the mizvah is sheit asseku b'mishnah. They shall toil, they should work in the Mishnah. Barur shekavanat Rashi ha-pishuta hi l'tares koshi. Obviously we understand that when Rashi is coming to give us, you know, these lines, he's trying to explain some whatever question may be. Im ze Mishnah, im זה משנה מכוונת לספר המשנה המסוי בידינו. If this term, משנה, is referring to the book of משנה that we now currently have, הלא הוא נכתב על ידי רבי יהודה הנשיא. The משנה we have was written, obviously, much later, by Rabbi Yehuda הנשיא. ואיך יכול משה למקבל את המשנה? How can we say that Moshe received the משנה? לכן רשי מסביר. Therefore, רשי is explaining. לא שקיבל משה את המשנה, אלא שקיבל שהתעסקו במשנה. Not that משה רבנו actually received משנה, but rather that they should work in the משנה. They should be involved in the משנה. כלומר, meaning what? שיש סינור, סינור מסוים של לימוד של דבר השם, שבא בבחינה תורה שבעל פה, וצריך להתעסק בו. That there is a specific pipeline of learning of the words of God that came in, we call it in the sense of Torah SheBa'al Peh, in the oral law, and you have to be involved in it. Me'uhar yoter hu nikhtab b'sefer Mishnah. And later on, all those learnings were written down in the book of the Mishnah.
Received the Mishnah.
He received the Torah SheBa'al Peh. Right. He received the oral law. Right. Not the Mishnah not the book Mishnah, that we know right. today, obviously.
Right.
And that's what Barry said before. As it was being right. forgotten, you know, they right. started writing it down. And obviously, right. they only wrote down whatever was remembered.
Right.
אך אותו סגנון לימודי הבא לידי ביטוי במשנה הוא שקיבל משה מסיני. But this style of limud, this style of learning that came to light in the Mishnah is based upon whatever Moshe accepted and received at Sinai. Binimdal min haketub. And this is a separate thing that he received at Sinai apart from the written Torah, which we call Mikra. So far we're clear. Lefi zeh mitba'arim debir Rashi, shemizva lekro b'Torah misad asma, ולא בתור מקור למשנה. Now we understand from Rashi that there's a mitzvah to read in the Torah for its own sake, and not because it is part of being mitasek b'mishnah, of being involved in the Mishnah. So we have the Mikra, we have to read the Kira, we have the mitzvah to read the Kro. Step one mizvah, and we have another separate mizvah of being mitasig b'mishnah. Im be'emet Am Yisrael haya mitragel likro b'katub misad asmo. If Am Yisrael actually got into the habit of reading Torah SheBikhtab, reading the Humash, reading the Mikra, Yitachin Sheherbe Ta'uyot Behabanat Mahalacha Historia Hayu Nachsechot. It's very, very possible that many mistakes in knowing the history of Am Yisrael would have never occurred. They would all fall to the wayside. The Mashal, Im Hayu Regilim Yote Bekriyat HaTanach Kifi Shehu, if they got into the habit, more into the habit of reading the Torah Nebim Ketuvim, okay, the way it is, Yitachin Shekol Hitnagdut L'Siyunot Lo Hayta Kama, all the negativity, all the opposition, all to Zionism, but have never happened. Torah is all talking about going to Sion. The Nevi'im going to Sion. The Ketuvim going to Sion. It's all about our aspiration to be in Sion. That's the Sionut. That is Zionism. Abel, mekevan shetragelu lilmod Torah SheBikhtab rak derech hedrachut ha-ma'asiyot shel Torah SheBa'al Peh. And since, for some reason, this branch of the Torah, Torah SheBikhtab, was forgotten, they didn't learn it, and they only happened to learn it, some pisukim here and there, by chance, through their learning of Torah SheBa'al Peh, Nishkeha Hamagama Hakolele Shel Historia Shatorah SheBikhtab Melamed Otanu. They forgot all the history, the rich history that is written down in the Torah SheBikhtab, that is who we are, and directed us all these years. Now, Marky pulled up over here for us the Rambam. We're in the Hara. Okay, this is the Hakdamah of the Rambam to the Mishneh Torah. Not the Hakdamah of the Rambam to the Mishnah, but to his Mishneh Torah. Kol ha-mizvot shenitenu lo le-Moshe b-Sinai b-Pirushan nitenu. Okay? All the mizvot that were given to Moshe Rabbeinu on Har-Sinai were given to him with their explanation. Shenimah b-Tina lecha et luchot ha-Evin v-Torah v-Mizvah. How does he explain it? Here, Rambam, Torah zo, Torah SheBikhtab. Veha mizvah zo, Perusha. So he's saying mizvah is called Perusha. He's saying mizvah is SheBa'al Peh. Same thing, in a sense. Vesivanu la'asu ha-Torah al-Pi ha-Mizvah. And he commanded us to do the Torah based upon the mizvah. In other words, Torah SheBikhtab, Torah SheBa'al Peh have to work hand in hand. U-mizvah zo hi ha-Nikret Torah SheBa'al Peh. Mizvah is what? Torah SheBa'al Peh. Kol ha-Torah kataba Moshe Rabbeinu kodem sheyamut b'chtab yado. The entire Torah was written by Moshe Rabbeinu before he died. And he wrote it in his own hand. V'natan sefer l'chol shevet v'shevet b'sefer echad nitenahu baron la'ad. And he gave one sefer to each of the 12 Shebatim and one sefer Torah they put in the Aron of the Mishkan for eternity. Shinemar lakoh at sefer Torah ze vesamtem oto. The mizvah she pirush ha Torah, and the mizvah which is the pirush of the Torah, in other words, the Torah SheBa'al Peh, lo ketaba, he did not write it. Ela siva ba lezikenim lehoshua lishaar kol Yisrael. He commanded it. He taught it over to Yehoshua, to the zikenim, etc., and to the other people. Shinemar kol davar asher anochi misavei etchem oto tishmeru la'asot. Since it was taught orally and handed over orally, that's what it's called Torah SheBa'al Peh. It is the oral Torah. Af al pi shelo nichteba Torah SheBa'al Peh l'meda Moshe Rabbeinu kulla bebet dino l'shibaim zekinim. Even though Torah SheBa'al Peh was not written, Moshe Rabbeinu taught the entire thing to the entire bet din of 70 elders. And the three people that received it directly from Moshe were Elazar, Pinehas, and Yehoshua. Now, Yehoshua, Shu'utal Midosh, Moshe Rabbeinu, Masar, Torah, SheBa'al Peh, Siva, Odeh, and etc. And he's going to go on and on, he's going to go through the generations.
But, yeah, so I brought it up just because he does mention that the Kitab doesn't come
Mm-hmm.
The Mikra doesn't come.
But he, what he's saying is that Kol haTorah ketava Moshe Rabbeinu kodem sheyamut bichtav yado. That's the line that you're pointing to.
Right.
That the entire Torah was written by Moshe Rabbeinu before he passed away, in his own hand.
But what he was teaching...
In his own hand. In other words, he himself wrote it.
But what he was teaching before that was teaching the mitzvah.
He was teaching what was given to him orally.
Right.
Right.
And
that remained oral.
And then he wrote it?
Events that didn't happen yet, obviously he wrote it.
Right.
Yeah, he expounds more on this in the Hakdama of the Mishnah. Mm-hmm. But that's what I was getting to.
Okay, next section from Rabbi Cherki. Hamizva zo hamishnah. Let's see what he has to say now. Od alinu lilmod. שהדרכה המעשית כיצד לנהג אינה נלמדת מהתורה שבכתב. The direction, the path to learn how to conduct oneself is not learned from Torah שבכתב, אלא מהתורה שבעל פה, rather from Torah שבעל פה. אם ליהודי יש שאלה כיצד לבנות סוכה, if a Jew has a question, how to build a סוכה, הוא פונה אל המשנה. He has to turn to the Mishnah. והתורה שבכתב, לא דיברה על כך. תורה שבכתב doesn't discuss it. דוגמה בולטת יש בשאלת הפרי הניטל בסוכות. A issue that stands out is clearly the fruit that we lift up on Sukkot. שלפי המסורת הוא אתרוג. According to our tradition, it's an אתרוג. בתורה כתוב משהו אחר. בתורה, תורה שבכתב, says otherwise. It says, פרי עס הדר, right? ויקרא, פרי פרי עס הדר, תמרים, פרי נחל, נפס עבות, we know the פסוקים. חזל מסכת סוכה, סוכה למד ה' עמוד א', מפלפלים על מנה להוכיח שפרי עס הדר הוא אתרוג. So the חכמים in the Gemara, מסכת סוכה, they go back and forth at it to try to prove that פרי עס הדר is in fact the אתרוג. האופן שבו הם מוכיחים לכאורה זר מאוד. But if we look at their discussion in the Gemara, it's very strange. Let's follow it. פרי עס הדר. עס שטעם עסו ופריו שווה. It's a tree that the taste of the bark and of the fruit is equal. הווה אומר, זה אתרוג. Okay, let's say this is etrog. Ve'ema pelpelin bidetanya. Hara hayar bimir omer. Mimashma shne emar. Muntatim kul ais. Any yodea shu ais ma'achal. Matamun omar ais ma'achal. Ais shetam asmo upriyo shave. How could you call a ais ma'achal? The ice being food. It can only be if the ice itself tastes like the actual food. Heve omer, ze pelpelin. Lemetcha, she pelpelin hayabin ba'ola, ve'en Israel hasera kelum. Shineemar, not hasar kol ba. Hata mishum de la efshar. Hechina abid, min kot hada. Lemin kera. Ninaki Nkotare Otilata 2 or 3. Ahad Amara Hamana Veloshena Ushlosha Perot Hilkahlo Ifshar Ribi Omer Atri Hadar Illa Hadir Madir Zeyeshbo Gidulim Gidulim Ktanim Timimim Ubaalim Umin Hakiname Yeshbo Gidulim Ktanim Timimim Ubaalim Umin Toshar Perot لبهو جدولين مكتنين وتميمين وبعلم مميمين what only the etrog you have big ones and small ones and clean ones and blemished ones it makes no sense all fruit have you know different types any fruit tree you go to the fruit are not the same إلا هاكي كامار عاد شبائين كتنين عدام جدولين كيمين now even until the small ones come you already have big ones ربي أبو أمار أتخي هدار illa dabar shidar bilanu mishana shana. Min azay omer atri hadar illa idur shekem bishon yivani konin la mayim idur vezu hi shegadal al kol mayim heve omer ze etrog. And in truth, this is a very strange discussion to try to figure out what the etrog is, or to
this is the Gemara.
Masechet Sukkah. To classify and qualify the etrog as being Pirei Es Hadar. It's a pretty strange discussion. The fruit is the same, only one fruit, two fruit, three fruit. No, let's call the word, let's not call it Hadar, let's call it Hadir. No, let's call it Hadir, let's call it Dabar. Let's not call it Dabar, let's call it Idur.
Right, so he's saying to find out what the etrog was.
To justify that our tradition, that, you know, of using etrog is really the Pirei Es Hadar talked about in the Gemara. No, you can't find it in Torah,
right.
But obviously just going to this discussion in the Gemara is also, you know, not exactly all there.
Right.
We have tradition. So let's see.
But these are like espachta. It's like,
we're not saying they're not.
No, I'm just saying that's what the whole, just to say, like, what were they thinking? What were they arguing? They're
right,
not arguing.
So obviously,
they're just getting pisukim to justify it.
But obviously, what we read over here is not the Torah SheBa'al Peh that Moshe Rabbeinu gave us.
Right.
Okay? Things were forgotten over
that's
time.
Right. What was explained to Moshe
right.
Rabbeinu? Etrog.
So let's see what he's saying here.
Pirei Es Hadar, right.
Right. What's Pirei Es Hadar? That yellow thing over there.
Right.
That yellow bumpy guy.
From the right.
Okay. The fruit that you can't do anything with, basically.
Right. They didn't have illustrators in time, Moshe.
No, they had illustrators in time, Moshe. Look at the pyramids.
Yeah,
Barur kashemish. It's as clear as day, he's telling you. Shelo yitahqin shehachamim bayyom min hayyamim kar'u batorah peri'i sadar ve'etheilu lish'ol et asmam ma peru shemilim danu upilpilu ve'egiu la maskana sheze etrog. Says, it can't be. Once upon a time, way back in the days of Moshe Rabbeinu, that the Hachamim sat down, right? The Shevim Zekirim, they sat down. What does this thing, Pirei Es Hadar? Let's have a weird discussion like this, like that we just had in, you know, in Gemara Sukkah. No! Obviously, they knew what it was. It's only later on, as things have get forgotten, so then we have to make up these Pirushim. Mishlahar mekin hodiu lechol am Yisrael shemikon al habas liqatrog. And then they went and told the people, when you read Pirei Es Hadar, you know what it is? It's this. And then everybody knows. Every Sukkot, what do we take? This. It's etrog. What's Pirei Es Hadar? Pirei Es Hadar. That's it. Keep it in your head and leave it there. Mishlahar mekin hodiu lechol am Yisrael shemikon al habas liqatrog etrog. Barush adabar hayyaduha. It's crystal clear. This was a well-known thing. Lo yitachin omar shem makor shel devarim yeh bepasuk. Obviously, we know that the source is not the pasuk. Kemo ken lemashal, kishigemara b'masechet berachot. Look at something else in Masechet Berachot. Ein omdin hitpalel ella mitoch kobed rosh. Okay, can't stand to pray except mitoch kobed rosh. Mina hanemeli. Where do we get this from? Where do we learn it from? What is this going on? Minayin shesarich hitpalel toch kobed rosh. Okay, where do we get this concept that we have to pray only toch kobed rosh? What's the best way to translate kobed rosh to?
The concentration.
It's concentration, but
the more
there's a better literal.
Oh no. A heavy head, it means.
It's I know it means heavy head.
No, I'm just saying it means
not
like,
heavy.
It means like a seriousness.
Seriousness,
like
yeah,
focus,
seriousness.
Focus, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But more than focus. It's like with it's almost like with
so awe. Did you say anything maybe like kavanah?
Yeah, it's
like,
definitely like kavanah, but
meditation. But that's more like.
It's not. No, let's use a serious focus, combination of the two terms. Lechora, in sorech bepasuk kedei lada'at shekach yesh la'asot shekin kach tamid asu. We don't need a pasuk to tell you this, because it's what was always done. Ubchol zot, Mubaim Basugya Hamisha Pesukim Bidok Makor. But there's still the Hakain that bring us five different Pesukim as a source. Ella Shadiyun Hu Beemet Al Sug Kobet Harosh and Drash. But rather, if you look carefully at the discussion, it's what kind of Kobet Rosh? Lachen Sarikh the Pesukim Ella. That's why we need the Pesukim. Shkola Had Lefi Tochno. Because each one of them in their context is able to emphasize a certain aspect of the Kobed Rosh. But it's clear to us that it's not because of these Pesukim that we know we have to pray with Kobed Rosh. We know we have to pray with Kobed Rosh because this is what Moshe Rabbeinu already told us. Expand a little bit. נאמר בתורה, בפרשת שלח, דבר את בני ישראל, ואמרת להם, ועשו להם, ססיד על כנפי בכדיהם לדור אותם. Great. Simple פסוק, we all know, we say it, you know, at least twice a day. אחרי שהוא שמע את המילים האלה, after he heard these words, לימד משה את בני ישראל, שיש לעשות ססיד בכנף הבגד, וגם את אופן עשייתה. When Moshe Rabbeinu learned this, he taught it to Am Yisrael, that they have to do the sasid in the corner of the beged, of the garment, and he told them how to do it. Lo she'alu et b'nei Yisrael b'shelav zeh, madua hem atirim sasid b'chdehem, hayu onim shekach siva Hashem Moshe. Right? There's no question. V'chol zeh od b'terem nechtevu ha'devarim b'torah. And there's also when the stuff was being first written in the Torah. La'har kitibatam, ma ya'asu im yir'u sitira, and what if once the Torah is now written, what if they see a discrepancy between what Moshe told them and what Moshe, you know, wrote? Now what? Barur shinahagu lefid ibn Moshe. It's clear that they're going to follow what Moshe taught them. They heard it directly from him. They're not going to rely upon what they think they're figuring out from the pasuk. Because they know what Moshe taught them. Zot omeret, Shema sheneemar hu hamakor fel hasamchut velo ma shenichtav. This comes to prove to us that what do we rely upon? What is the source? Well, it's the source that we're relying upon is the oral tradition that was given to us directly from Moshe, and not what is written in the Pesukim that needs to be deciphered or we cannot clearly comprehend or understand. Hadibarim Miforashim Gambarashbam. And the concept that we're talking about is explained clearly in the Rashbam. Vahaya lechali ot al yadecha. Lefi omek pishuto ye lechali zikaron tamir ki ilukatub al yadecha ki ain simeni kahotam al libecha. Okay. It's like putting a ring on your heart. Simeni kahotam. Okay, it's like a signet ring, okay, on your heart. Obviously, you know, we're not putting a signet ring, and we're not putting a heart. We know what it is. It was handwritten. What's this ot? Well, what's this sign, ot? You know, we know. We have a tradition right from Moshe Rabbeinu. He showed us. This is a tefillin. This is what you're wearing. Done. Zot omer shelefi harashbam hakatub lo siva laniyah tefillin. The katub, the mikra, does not tell us anything about wearing tefillin. As למה רשב"ם מניח תפילין? So why did רשב"ם wear תפילין? משום שמשה אמר לנו מפי הגיבורה להניח תפילין. Because בורא העולם told Moshe, Moshe told us, that's what we do. אבל הכתוב לא אמר את זה. But if you look at the Mikra, it does not say anything about תפילין. It doesn't use the word תפילין. It doesn't give us a description of תפילין. Tells us nothing. This is the tradition. This is what was handed to us from day one. That's Torah SheBa'al Peh.
Is tefillin.
Right. For that. We just say that.
What's
what the things are.
Very important.
It's very important. This is a good foundation.